Did you realize that it is very surprising that Taylor series work at all? You are only using local information about the function to compute function values that may be very far away. This is due to Taylor's inequality. We'll use it in this video in a few examples to get a feeling for the number of terms we need to include in order to get a good approximation. So, as our first example, we use again f of x exponential function around 0, so we know it's capital nth order Taylor polynomial because all the derivatives are 1, and then we know due to Taylor's inequality we can pick any d. Then as long as capital X is smaller than this d, then we know that nth derivative of f of x, well, keep on differentiating, so still e to the power x, which will be smaller than e to the power d. So we can choose as our m e to the power d in our Taylor's inequality. Then that says that our remainder is smaller or equal than m, which we chose as e to the power d, a bound on the derivative, divided by capital N plus 1 factorial times x absolute to the power n plus 1. Now we see that for all x in this interval minus dt, this x to the power n plus 1 will be some finite number. However, this n plus 1 factorial blows up, so dividing by that means that our quotient goes to 0. So it means that in the limit, this remainder equals 0. And then we know, according to the theorem, that in fact the exponential function is equal to its Taylor series, 1 over n factorial times x to the power n. So, second example, do the cosine of x, again around 0. Well, we know it's Taylor series, did that before. We know it's n's Taylor polynomial as well, sum from 1 to capital N, and then minus 1 to the power n divided by 2n factorial times x to the power 2n. Now, in order to be able to use Taylor's inequality, we need again a bound on the n derivative. Well, that's nice because the cosine becomes a minus sine and minus cosine and sine, etc. But all those functions are bound between minus 1 and 1. So we know that the n derivative will be smaller or equal than 1 anyway. So we can choose as our capital M, m equals 1. Then we know that our n derivative is below this n. And we can use again Taylor's inequality, which says that the remainder smaller or equal than this capital M, well, you can't see it anymore because it's 1, divided by n plus 1 factorial times x to the power n plus 1. And again, for all finite x, if capital N goes to infinity, x to the power n plus 1 is some finite number, and you divide by n plus 1 factorial, which goes to infinity, so you have something finite divided by infinity equals 0 in the limit. So the remainder goes to 0, which means that cosine of x equals its Taylor series. Does it always work? Well, now we go to our third example. F of x equals the absolute value of the cosine of x. And we again compute the Taylor series around a equals 0. Well, around 0, the absolute value of the cosine of x and the cosine of x itself, they are the same. So around 0, you get all the same derivatives. So the Taylor polynomial of the cosine absolute and the Taylor polynomial of the cosine are the same. But let's see what happens if we plot those in one figure. The white over here is the Taylor polynomial, arbitrarily far as you like, and the red curve is the function absolute value of the cosine of x. And you'll see at this part you are fine. The Taylor polynomial or the Taylor series and the function are the same. But on those parts here, they do not agree anymore at all. So, why is that? Well, in this case, you cannot estimate your Rn, you cannot get your Rn to 0. And you see also why, because in order to get your Rn to 0, you need to be able to estimate derivatives. And as you see over here, for example, the derivative blows up, you get a cusp. So you can't estimate your Rn, so you do not know whether your remainder goes to 0. So you are not sure that your Taylor series will approximate your function, and as you see from your graph, indeed your Taylor series does not approximate your function anymore well So you see, for the nicely behaving functions, your Taylor polynomial will approximate your function good. But as soon as you get something like this, like those cusps, etc., then you have to be really careful with this.